In this video, I'll try to uncover the prototype's identity. So far, we only have the prototype's arm and no information about him. But I think I managed to dig up some new info that you probably haven't heard anywhere else. The introduction to the prototype occurs in the first chapter. At the end of the chapter, we find a cassette, a video diary from one of the scientists of the Playtime Corporation. The diary consists of 9 recordings. From the recordings, we learn that the object itself shows no signs of activity and is in a deep sleep state. But the experiment doesn't go as planned. The prototype got out of control and killed some of the scientists. The remaining scientists decide to continue the experiment, as they say, all for the sake of science. They build a special laboratory that will protect the scientists in case another prototype goes out of control. However, the laboratory fails to fulfill its functions, and during another incident, the remaining scientists die at the hands of the prototype. Though we've only seen prototype's hand, I'm inclined to believe this thing already has some kind of endoskeleton that helps it move around the building. Think of it as one of those endoskeletons from Five Nights at Freddy's. But the only difference is that its body doesn't allow him to act on any grand scheme he has. So now other toys are doing it for him. Now, knowing all the events from all 3 chapters, we know that not every toy belongs to Prototype. But those who aren't can still be aggressive and intend to kill. For example, Mommy Longlegs seems genuinely afraid of Prototype, as when she's dragged into the grinder, she screams that he will make me a part of himself, implying that she understood Prototype's goal in building himself. Now, however, this mostly confirms that whatever Prototype looked like before Mommy Longlegs' death, he definitely changed. But we don't know if he took parts from Huggy Wuggy, let alone finding him. When we eventually killed him, he fell into the depths of Playtime Co., and there's a chance that when he landed, parts of him became unrecognizable. However, we can bet that whenever Prototype is revealed, he will definitely have a part of Mommy Longlegs on some part of his body. Now, this leads to the question, what would Prototype take from Mommy Longlegs? The instinctive answer is her arms and legs, since she can stretch my legs for several feet, and they seem extremely strong. Well, if you look closely at Playtime, you will see that several employees were taken away by Mommy Longlegs with one hand. So if Prototype took anything from her, it would definitely be that. But the fact is, he didn't. If you remember what happened after we killed Mommy Longlegs, you can see that Prototype only took her torso and right arm, while the rest of Mommy Longlegs' limbs were spoiled by the grinder. Does this mean that Prototype will have one arm to reach out, and he will keep the one he already has? Okay, this thing is our only clue about Mommy Longlegs. I think we can consider this a possibility. But what about some other characters who died? For some time, we were made to believe that Catnap would be one of the characters used to make Prototype stronger, especially since Prototype has access to his entire body, including his breathing system, which holds red smoke. Catnap doesn't just have some stock of red smoke inside him. He literally just regularly exhales it. And knowing that Prototype possesses intelligence like no one else, there's a chance that he could extract red smoke from Catnap and apply it in his arsenal. And if you really think about it, he can't extract anything else from Catnap. Maybe his limbs to have claws and a more agile physique. But something tells me that there will be another character, parts of which Prototype will tear off body parts and attach to himself. Could it be one of these characters, smiling creatures? Honestly, it's unlikely that we know anything about the abilities of the smiling creatures after the Big Bodies initiative. And judging by how quickly they died, Prototype might not even consider them worthy of use. Plus, it was implied that Piggy ate all the smiling creatures. So even if Prototype wanted to use them, he simply couldn't. Wait a minute. Dogday had his legs cut off as torture for ordering everyone from Playcare and Playtime Co. Could he also be in addition to Prototype? I guess that's also a no, simply because the reason Dogday's legs were cut off in the first place was to torture him. But on the other hand, when we meet the dog in the prison cell, his legs are nowhere, so they could have been preserved somewhere else. Or they were just eaten by Catnap and the little smiling creatures. Now at the end of chapter 3, we hear Kissy Missy being attacked, And if you guys want me to make a theory about who did it, let me know in the comments. You need to be cautious. There's something, what you're doing. But if we assume that the person who attacked Kissy Missy was Prototype, then it really could make sense. Because of one thing I mentioned earlier, when Huggy Wuggy died, he fell deep into Playtime Co., and it's quite possible that his remains were never found. Perhaps Huggy Wuggy's death in such a way wasn't part of Prototype's plan, and he wanted to extract something from him to become stronger. But Kissy Missy is largely an exact copy of Huggy Wuggy, with the only difference being her face color and a more caring character. Yes, it's possible. But if it happened, what would Prototype take from Kissy Missy? The only useful thing Prototype could take is her mouth, as it has dozens of uneven needle-like teeth, and it could serve as an effective weapon because if he needs to kill someone else, another character we can include in this list is Miss Delight. But honestly, there are no compensating parts on her that Prototype would find useful. Even her weapon could be considered useless, as Prototype already has a claw capable of easily killing other toys. Plus, it's literally just a bunch of sharpened colored pencils attached to some random brain. We can also rule out Bunzo Bunny from the list because one, he doesn't make it out, and two, he was killed by Mommy Longlegs. And after he was killed, his body is nowhere to be found, so he was probably eaten. But now, with everything laid out on the table, it's time to speculate about what Prototype actually looks like after the events of Chapter 3. And the main thing we're going to use to help us is the Temple of Catnap. Before entering it in the playhouse, we see Catnap praying to this strange combination of toys. And after he finally returned to Playcare Center, Ollie informs us that Catnap made it for Prototype. But there's something about what Ollie said that stuck with me. If you thought that was terrifying, just wait until you see the real thing. Does this mean that Catnap and Ollie have seen Prototype? Ollie says that essentially means Catnap tried hard to make a statue of Prototype, and the statue he made pales in comparison to how whimsical the real appearance of Prototype is. So if we're going to use this as a basis for what Prototype looks like, let's start by examining the temple itself. It seems like Catnap found a part of Mommy Longlegs. As you can see, her hand and wrist on the statue, and I assume that all this extraction on the right is supposed to serve as Prototype's hand, and everything else is just added on top of his exoskeleton. And for some reason, you can also see a worker's skeleton sticking out of the mouth of Pugapilar. Now, still I'm not sure Prototype will have the bodies of his victims, but we just need to look. But one thing that strikes me is the fact that some of the many smiling creatures are here. I thought they were all still alive because they sided with Catnap in Prototype to avoid death. At this point, everything is just a mess. But one thing we can know for sure, once we see some recognizable details on Prototype, he has executed his plan. But what do you think Prototype looks like? Let me know in the comments.